What is up, everybody? We are back. Saturday morning. We're back at it with another chill gaming stream, if you will. Oh, I'll address it now, and then, you know, that'll be my... Oh, I hear a bird outside. I was like, what the fuck is that noise? You know, I'll address it at the beginning of stream right now. You know, yesterday's stream got a little wacky, got a little out of control. I ended up fucking passing the fuck out really early. Friday night shenanigans, you know, leading into some Saturday morning shenanigans. I don't know if I got a chance to do it last night because I was a tad bit out of it, but I would like to thank everybody who sent me donations yesterday. I appreciate the fuck out of that. We got a... let me try to see that here. Where's my dashboard? Okay, good. This isn't on stream. Yeah, we got two donations yesterday. We got a $10 from Cyber Katie, and then we got another one from Kangalope. $10 from Cyber Katie, Belinda's God. That was so true, so accurate. And then a $4.20 from Kangalope. I appreciate the fuck out of the donations, guys. Like, no cap. Like, seriously. No cap. But for real, though, like, I appreciate the fuck out of all the support with donations and stuff like that. It helps keep the dream alive, if you will. Okay, so we're hopping back into some gaming. I don't know if, I'm going to watch anything. There were some videos actually kind of on my radar. I was thinking about maybe watching one of them. I actually might do that. Let me pull up a tab here. YouTube. Okay. I want to see who's been talking about the Dark Viper AU situation. Dark Viper drama. Tom Dark, there's a stream segment. Doomer Media, who is very controversial. He had his own takes on the Dark Viper situation, and I don't know if I want to... I don't know. Do we give Doomer Media the, do we give him the okay? I kind of want to see his video on it and see how he's, addressing it. Dark Viper AU versus Chud Logic React drama. I don't know. I don't really like that Doomer Media guy. A lot of these videos are just so long. I'm trying to look for something short and sweet, bro. AU drama is what I'm going to say. Drama farming. Chris the Narc talked about it. Let's watch Chris's video on it.
Hey guys, welcome back to another upload.
Hey guys, welcome back. It's ya boy, Christopher the Narkler. Christopher Narcan. Coming at ya. His face right here looks so fucking hilarious. Window keeps ya. Dark Viper. Yeah, there we go. Let me make sure the alerts can still come through. Like there. Yeah. That's good. I don't think the alerts will be covered up, really. We're going to watch Christopher Narcan's video on the Dark Viper situation. We're going to give our thoughts.
Upload White Mudahar here.
White Mudahar. Let's see if make sure the volume's good.
We're going to be talking about my favorite speedrunning lolcow, Dark Viper. Now, if you don't know anything about Dark Viper, you're new to this channel or anything, I recommend you go and watch my previous coverage of it. I'm going to link it all in the description here for you. If you want to get caught up to all the context, Dark Viper essentially has been going on a bit of a... What's the nicest way?
Tirades.
A meltdown. He's basically falling apart at the seams, which is really curious because how this drama started is that he falsely struck Chud Logic's channel over a reaction video that he did to his content. Chud reacted to it for an additional 23 to 30 minutes, while Dark Viper's original video was only 9 minutes. Chud gave scathing criticism of that video, and Dark Viper got his panties in a twist and struck his channel. And the funniest part about that is for 6 whole months, him and his lawyer have been constantly doing updates to YouTube and continuously demanding that strike to go through until YouTube lamented because they said, man, we can't handle this autism anymore.
I got an email advising me of the copyright strike that was applied to my channel. And this copyright strike was filed by a lawyer. So Dark Viper, who was unhappy with the result of the previous drama, because his DMCA, despite all his claims that he was the expert and was knew what he was doing, got knocked back by YouTube twice because he probably didn't fill out the form correctly, hired a lawyer.
So basically everyone's just been dunking on Dark Viper, and Rapsion, funny enough, now known as Darth Potato. What's that name, dude?
What
this clip
fuck?
Is of a particular moment where Dark Viper was doing a live stream with fans.
Oh, shit.
A guy comes into the game that they're playing Among Us.
What the fuck? Yo, this is the Christopher Narcan right here. That's the face. Dude, what the fuck? How do I screenshot? How do I screenshot again? Yeah. The whole thing. that's such a good fucking still. Oh, my God.
Us? And Dark Viper has a full-blown mental breakdown that this guy failed and caused Dark Viper to lose the game.
And Chilo just runs around the entire fucking map to come to O2. And I'm like, I had nothing to say. I was literally speechless. I did not speak that entire time because I was so confused why we were still in the game. I have never been this mad at a person the entirety of my life.
Jesus, ear rape warning. Fuck, I should have warned you guys. Ear rape, Dark Viper, is screaming over the game Among Us, just to give some clarification. He's literally playing Among Us, a game quite literally meant for 5-year-olds, and he's genuinely letting himself get this upset over it, alright? Like, I understand raging at a video game, I get it, right? But, dude, you are legitimately getting seriously upset to the point that you are, like, unwell, mentally.
I apologize, I'm still a little new at the game.
And the guy even says, he's like laughing, he's like, I apologize, I'm still kind of new at the game, bro. And Dark Viper's like, why? He goes on to say, why are you even playing the game if you don't know how to win? And it's like, dude, calm the fuck down, dude. It's fucking Among Us, dude. What is your problem?
If you don't even know how to win the game, why are you playing?
That's way too fucking loud, bro. I don't know if it's Christopher's editing. I don't know what the fuck exactly. Jesus Christ. Like,
I do. I'm just sorry. I mix.
Now, as you can see there, that is a very, very, very normal reaction to losing a game of Among Us. Now, Dark Viper has been blocking everybody. He's been on a blocking spree ever since the Chud Logic situation happened. But for some reason, this particular clip got him so pissed, he made a 9-minute response video to everybody laughing at him.
So just before I went live, this clip got reposted on Twitter from someone named Darth Potato. How can a grown man become this angry over Among Us, Lamel? Chill out, Dark Viper, you eat a Snickers, pray to Jesus, or maybe touch some grass. This clip, no joke, is now 4 years old. It was covered in the story.
First off, who cares how old it is, bro? Who cares how old the fucking clip is, bro? If it makes you look bad, bro, you're like a 30-year-old man, dude. What do you mean this was 4 years ago? It's not like, oh, that was when I was like a young kid or something and I was more immature. Buddy, figure it out, dude.
One of my biggest controversies 10 months ago where I explained the whole story. So I'd largely be covering it again.
Dude, I get it. It happened 4 years ago. It doesn't matter. It's on the internet forever.
Yeah.
And nobody was paying attention to you.
Bro.
Now that you invoke the Streisand effect, striking Chud Logic's channel, falsely, I might add, in my opinion, now everyone's digging through everything and seeing how much of a spurg you are, how much of a complete lolcow you are, in the funniest ways possible. That clip, doesn't matter how old it is, it's really, really funny to laugh at you. And the fact that you made a 9-minute response video to this is insane to me.
Yeah, it was not a very nice clip. But as I say down here, this was 4 years ago. I was going through some personal stuff, like a lot of personal stuff. Just got diagnosed with Hashimoto's disease.
Listen, I don't care what disease you have. You have severe autism, is what we have here.
Agreed.
We have... Listen, you can't just blame it on that. Now, do I care, personally, about this? Not really. It's just really funny. Dude, you had a cringe moment like every other live streamer and gamer, and you turn it into a 9-minute response video because everyone's laughing at you. You're a loser.
I was figuring out my treatment. Like, I was just chemically not doing well. I communicated I wasn't doing well beforehand. Like, it was like a whole speech at the beginning of the stream, which I no longer have.
Plot twist, Dark Viper, nobody fucking cares, bro.
I was like, man, I'm doing like the worst I've ever been doing in the entirety of my life. I just want to play Among Us and chill. Anyone who doesn't know how to play, please don't play. I just want to have like a smooth experience. And yeah. Scott, who was the target of my outburst, understood. And he forgave me and we played mini games after. He comes around occasionally. He's VIP in chat and all that jazz. It's like one on the bridge within like 2 days. But this clip has now been referenced 100 times. And it's frustrating because with the context, obviously it's not particularly bad.
No, Viper. It was bad. Not because people are criticizing you about it, which, yeah, people could say, dude, it's crazy that you even did that in the first place. It's just funny. It's pathetically funny. That is why people are talking about it. I don't care that you blew up on a view. I just think it's really funny that people like you, speedrunners, all have moments like this. Let's watch a brief compilation real quick of that. See, Dark Viper, it's not just you. Every speedrunner gets laughed at this stuff because it's crazy that you guys freak out over a video game. You also freaked out when some guy beat the record that you wanted to get for no damage in GTA. You go to full-blown Reddit mod meltdown.
Literally, one of the biggest concerns I had with someone beating my time is knowing that no one's gonna give a shit who Unnamed is in a week. No one. No one will remember, no one will care. For me, people bring up Unnamed for me for the rest of my fucking life. I will be forever that guy who tried hard to beat Oko and did not succeed first. When I say he has made my life worse, measurably so. I was the only person who could have benefited significantly from doing this first. But not only that, failing to do this will now impact the rest of my career.
Dude, you are not stable.
Literally, I agree. This guy is severely not stable. Hey there. Oh, she's got a crow following her. Why were you AFK, girl? What are you doing? Go do something. This guy's unwell, like mentally. It's pretty fucked, if you ask me. It's not that, like, you know, I get, like, this is your career, this is what you do for a living, it's like speedrunning, like, that's your content, but, dude, you gotta take a step back. You gotta take a step back from the video games and don't let it rule your fucking mood like that, bro. I'd really like to just have a conversation with this guy, because he would try to turn it into some, I don't know, like, he would just try to turn it into some shit, like... You don't get it, you don't understand, but, dude, no, it's quite literally a fucking video game. Like, you gotta chill the fuck out, dude. It's not that deep. It's not that serious. It's not that deep. It's my personal fucking take.
You are insane. And so are your fans.
No one involved thought it was particularly bad. But, like, when you've streamed for 14,461 hours, yours there not being a 30-second clip where you look like an asshole is involved. And so there's one copy of this clip on YouTube. In other words, this dude drew 5260, and this small clip has enabled,
chaos,
like, at least 100 disingenuous people to use this clip for 4 years to attack with it. And I've questioned what to do about it for so long.
It is a fair clip. You even said for public discourse that clips like these can be used.
Yo, Neon and his girlfriend Sam were detained by Dubai police, Mr. Gamer. Is that why everyone's been talking about Neon? Neon got arrested. I saw a Drama Alert post on Twitter yesterday that was saying this is not true. Neon didn't get arrested. Like, I didn't even know what the drama on that was. But damn, Dubai police. Damn. What did they do? Why did they get detained? Do you know?
Now because everyone's laughing at you, you want to get rid of the video? You are out of your mind.
Because I don't know if Drew was hostile to me or something, or just being a dick or something, but I think he was in my Discord at one point. And so I've tried to reach out to him multiple times over the years to be like, hey, like, I don't think this clip existing is communicating the context of what happened, and I think it is just contributing to misinformation. Please take it down? But I've got no response.
Bro, literally, Dark Viper, who the fuck cares, bro? I don't think this provides the full context. Welcome to the fucking internet, dude. People can quite literally post whatever the fuck they want about you, dude. Like, people post misinformation all the time. Not even saying that this is, like, misinformation, but it's just, you know, like, what the fuck, dude? Oh, they got caught illegally filming. That fits the bill. That fits the bill with all those streamers. They try to go places that you're not allowed to film, and they're like, well, I'm a streamer. I can film. And it's like, nah, not in certain foreign countries. Probably not. I remember FoozyTube getting kicked out of all the casinos and shit when he was going through his manic tirade on Kick. He was getting kicked out of basically every casino and, like, hotel because he was filming when you're, like, famously not allowed to film in those casinos in Vegas. So, yeah.
Response. I'm not sure if I've ever gotten through because he doesn't seem to use the channel anymore, at least as of the past year. The back end doesn't enable me just to reach out to him via email or something because there is no email here. Since this clip has once again been brought up on Twitter by someone who's disingenuous, whatever, I've now set about striking this video. I don't want to, but fortunately YouTube does give you the option.
Why is Dark Viper of the opinion that everyone, like, has to be a genuine person if they're on the internet? That's what I want to understand. I want to know. He's like, this person is disingenuous, and it's like, okay, and? Like, what? There's a lot of shit that you've done, Dark Viper, that can really be taken as disingenuous, if you will. People have been saying he will face 1 year prison sentence, but there's no confirmation yet. I got you. We'll just have to see, bro. I mean, Johnny Somali got arrested in Japan, not for illegal filming, but he was arrested and detained for, like, a good period of time just due to him being a fucking nuisance, like a public menace to society, basically. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's brutal.
Option to give the person 7 days to take down the clip, or at least reach out to me or whatever and discuss it with me or something.
This is the problem, Dark Light. There's no misinformation. Even with the context, you look crazy. Plus, you have a history of doing these styles of meltdowns. You've done it with other viewers, other games you've done this with. You have a pattern of behavior, of acting crazy when things don't go your way during a game, which is just normal for speedrunners. We're laughing at you, and you are trying to debate whether why this clip should go down because it just doesn't make you look good? Is that why you wanted Chud Logic's video to go down? Because it didn't make you look good?
Inherently, yes, and I think Dark Viper might be too dense to even realize that's his reasoning. Like, 100% that's his reasoning. Is that it doesn't make him look good. And he's, like, offended by that. Deep down, that's my honest take.
There's something that you control the narrative. Almost to a haunting degree. You need to cut it out.
Before something happens to your channel. He doesn't seem to use his channel. And if it does get striked, it will go away in 3 months anyway. But I don't know, I just regret leaving it up as long as I did. What people want to paint me is this DMCA hungry guy. That's generally speaking not me. But I
bull! That's bull. That's bull. That's total bull. You wouldn't be threatening to strike this guy's channel over a clip. You wouldn't have struck Chud Logic if you weren't a DMCA hungry guy. You literally wrote a 14-page document, your exact words, about how you
Sorry, girl, I tried to heal you.
You strike these people.
I tried.
You are a DMCA happy individual. You are somebody that doesn't understand the harm that your actions pose to the overall ecosystem that is the internet. You don't get it. Your fans don't get it. They just do a lot of this to you. All day long, that's all they do it to. You have yet to have a group of people that are willing to push back on you like this. This isn't the speed running community. This is a totally different area you're in now. And you can't handle it. Because now the narrative has left your control. You have no control over it. Because of your actions. All of your content, all of your freakouts, all your crazy tweets, and everything is now up for scrutiny. This is the Streisand effect almost to a perfect degree. Struck Chud, and now everything's coming to bite you in the ass. You are a DMCA hungry person. That is what you are.
But I just think this clip is just contributing to misinformation.
Dark Viper's unhinged? I fucking agree. Oh, apparently Neon contacted Aiden to help bail him out. Holy fucking shit, dude. What, does Neon not have the coin to get out of fucking jail? A little broke boy. Broke ass. But yeah, Dark Viper is severely unhinged. I agree with that.
And I don't think I have some moral obligation to contribute or to allow misinformation, right? It's not like I'm hiding the clip. I've shown it in multiple videos. I've discussed it at length many times over the last 4 years. If you want to watch the clip, it exists in my content multiple times. But I just don't like the idea that you can watch it somewhere without any context of how it came to be and why.
So now it's not a factor of it being a public discourse clip. Now it's because it makes you look bad. You want to take it down. Come on, man. Why? You're making this too easy. The fact that you're making this video after you commented on British Runner's video... and now Doomer Media's exact words, g'day mods, gave me your video. You probably won't be surprised that I disagree with everything outside of the broad summary at the start. My response is too long for a comment, but I wrote a script and will ramble about it tomorrow. I appreciate that your critique comes from a place of sincerity and was mostly cordial. Wish you all the best. Edit. Here's the important part. Due to this petty online garbage spilling into my real life, I will no longer respond to this video. I have no idea if Doomer actually supports these people or not. But in my 10-year career, I have never experienced anything quite like this. Doomer is wrong. Factually and philosophically in a dozen ways. But the safety of myself and those I care about demands I engage no further. If Doomer is sincere and misguided, unaware of what he is supporting, then I'm sorry he got caught up in this. I need to accept that explaining why people are wrong is, unfortunately, not a good method of resolution for drama in the online ecosystem. Dark Viper, if you feel like you're in danger responding to people, why are you making this video about the Among Us clip and Repsion laughing at you? You have no idea what you're doing.
My throat is hoarse. The decaying city crumbles.
Now, there is another part of this. Now, there's this other part that is kind of important. Now, do I endorse everything the Farms ever does? No. But it needs to be brought up regardless.
I love how he called Kiwi Farms the Farms. Nice.
So, Alinar tweets out, Dark Viper is now striking clips uploaded by the Farms that have been uploaded for the express purpose of public discourse surrounding his controversies that is now happening on KF and elsewhere. This is interesting because in Dark Viper's second video, he is in no uncertain terms made clear that a clip that serves the public discourse is constructive and fair use by his standards. He said he wouldn't want to DMCA it. This is the most concrete example of Dark Viper lying about his standards and DMCAing clips for convenience and personal gain.
Bro, tell me why my fucking PS4 sounds like a jet turbine engine right now. Just for opening up the challenges menu. Opening up the challenges, it just fucking can't handle it apparently, dude. What the fuck?
Not for any principled position. There's no room for interpretation. If you're not convinced now, there's no hope for you. As you can see here, there is a thread on Dark Viper currently being made on Kiwi Farms. He actually found this thread. Oh, he found out all right. Just got the strikes a few hours ago. DMCA, DMCA, DMCA. Here's Dark Viper AU. Please stop harassing me. Reported to the state of art. 240p YouTube preview because I'm too dumb to back up my own videos. So not only is he DMCAing Chud Logic for criticism, he's DMCAing clips that make him look bad, and now he's also DMCAing links that are connected to a gossip forum.
Because that clip was still on YouTube, people who want to disingenuously attack me and present that one outburst as if that represents me as a person would still use that clip on occasion. And
the amount of times that this guy uses the word disingenuous and like attack and like malicious, bro, it leads me to believe that he probably had a very, very sheltered childhood. That's the only conclusion I can reach. Rationally, like, this dude is very sheltered.
So for the longest time, I wanted to take it down, just for the purposes of not making it easy for them. Because the channel that uploaded it didn't upload it for any constructive purpose. It was just there, right?
What do you mean, any constructive purpose? What the fuck is the constructive purpose to anything, bro? This is not like a fucking... This guy is so... This is what I'm saying, chat. This guy is so goddamn detached. Like, he just doesn't get it, dude. It wasn't up there for any constructive purpose. Look at the beginning of the internet, bro. Look at all those goofy-ass YouTube videos. What was the constructive purpose for, like, anything? Like, goofy videos. And you'd say, well, the constructive purpose was to make people laugh. And it's like, well, people are laughing at this shit. It's just that you're the one who's getting laughed at, and you don't fucking like that because you're sheltered and you're fucking stupid. I don't know, dude. Like, you're genuinely... I used to think that this guy, he was a fairly smart guy for the most part, but the more time that goes on, his IQ numbers are seriously dwindled, bro. Like, seriously. It's really weird.
And the person wasn't using their YouTube account anyway. And so recently, I struck it, but I gave the person 7 days to respond so they wouldn't get the strike, because I had no way of contacting them. I had actually had tried to contact them through other means, but they never got back to me. And by filing that 7-day strike thing, they actually got back to me. And so this story has a happy ending. Hey Viper, saw the takedown. I uploaded that clip like 3 years ago when I was 15. I honestly forgot it was even up. I'm sorry the clip being up caused this much drama. Keep up your work. Hope to see more speedrun stuff soon. I said, thanks mate, sorry for the bother, and thanks for watching my stuff. All good. I know you didn't mean anything by it.
So this is the thing. I don't care that you and him made nice. It's a clip. And the sheer fact that you were like, I don't know what to do. Like, maybe I have to strike it. See how crazy that is. It's a 29-second clip. It doesn't matter the full-blown context of it. You still look insane. This isn't an allegation of an essay or anything like that where context is the most important thing. This is raging. That is it. Not that deep. My God. Now, there's two last parts to this that I want to bring up before we end up the video. One is the response that Dark Viper's Discord for him making this video. His whole community is a hug box of people that Dark Viper can do no wrong, and they will continuously and always defend this guy. It's crazy. So I posted out the deriding from the Dark Viper fans in his Discord after the Among Us allegations came out is hilarious. So we have this person right here. Did I miss something? Or is it yet again in drama? That is not a good sign when your audience needs to ask you if you're in drama. Nah, it's resolved. Doesn't matter. It's not resolved. It's not. The Chud Logic thing isn't resolved. Him making terrible videos about everybody that are completely and utterly not even in actual reality hasn't been resolved. Him wanting to remove a video that makes him look bad on the internet isn't resolved. So this person's dumb and a mongoloid. Someone posted a clip of Dark Viper raging during an AU game 4 years ago, without the context of him not feeling well, health issues, etc. Guy got back to his copyright strike request basically with, hey, sorry, forgot he even uploaded that. Didn't mean to add internet problems. Bro. Who cares? I don't care about his health. He's still freaked out. He had a rage moment. It's funny to laugh at, because it's pathetic. And you not getting that is shocking to me. I'm stunned at how smoothly the AU clip drama ended. Drew Goat for that response. But seriously, if these people knew that he is a massive hypocrite, which I'm pretty sure there's somebody in this video right now, with all the things that we found, these people aren't going to like it. But as you can see, these people just continuously keep dick riding. Let's get to the most relevant part of the situation. The last part I wanted to bring up to you is actually somebody that has no relation to the drama whatsoever, and actually was a good friend of Dark Viper. His name is Carl Jobst. If you don't know Carl, I'm shocked that you don't. So Carl put out a tweet responding
to— What the fuck is that chick doing, bro? Come on. She didn't even let me heal her, bro. What the fuck?
To Nicholas DiOrio, who made a short summary of the drama on Twitter involving Dark Viper. Carl Jobst, I have known Dark Viper AU since 2018. When we were both still small, streamers trying to grow. Over the years, I believe we had become friends. I respected him, met him multiple times in person. I specifically brought my wife to a creator party because I wanted her to meet him. I valued him as a person. Recently, without notice, without warning, he banned me and removed me from all of his socials. This hurt me deeply. I reached out to ask why he had never. I reached out to ask why, and he never even bothered to reply and let me know what I had done. Dark Viper would spend his days arguing with random haters online, but when it comes to someone who cared about him and just wanted to know what I had done to hurt him, at this point, I do not care what his grievance is, but I do know that what he did to me was a terrible thing to do, and my opinion of him could now not be lower. Carl Jobst is a friend of his, and Dark Viper removed a friend. This is how he treats his friends. Dark Viper fans, think about how he treats the people that are criticizing. So after Carl makes that tweet, essentially telling everybody that he is pushing his own friends away, and they had some pretty choice words about Carl, which is insane to me that this is even where we're at now. It sounds like the YouTube drama subject. r/DarkViper is melting down after Carl called him out. Half of the people are arguing whether Carl Jobst is a Nazi, and the other half are having an existential crisis. I'm not going to try to justify or downplay Carl's feelings, but I think it probably has to do with being friends with Whiteness, who is a white supremacist. Edit, not the best, but this is what I could find. Also, I remember there was a video going over White News that I can't find, and I don't really know if Goose still holds his beliefs, but this is probably one of the reasons. Ganging up onto your 6-year friend when he is getting attacked by multiple channels, when he's getting shit from every Twitter user, is not what a good friend would do. He could have revealed this at a later time when Matt isn't already getting attacked by multiple channels. It's something he might regret later. But if all of a sudden you're blocked by somebody and he ignores you trying to at least know what happened to better yourself, that person isn't a friend anymore. At least not in my opinion. I wanted to leave a comment like this, but I was afraid. Even if a friend ghosted me like that, I still value the time we shared together enough to fuel the fire when they are already going through a rough time. It makes me wonder how much Carl really does hate him. Edit. This did actually happen to me, but I didn't wait for him to get into drama and then publicly call out how he's a bad friend. These people are insane. They're trying to insinuate these things? Dude, Dark Viper fanbase is crazy.
Hey guys, thank you for watching the clip. Thank you for using Opinion for doing the editing. Make sure you give them a follow on Twitter. And make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you are new. Check out the link in the description for the Lolcow trading card game. There's a brand new pack called Series X.
You gotta love how he's got the tipster AI voice as his fucking send off the video. That's awesome.
That pack has my card in it, the tipster cards as well. On top of that, there's a bunch of other cast characters in there. And we're also working towards an ultimate goal for that. So make sure you guys click on the link below. We're going to try and upload daily here and do live streams pretty often. So make sure you stick around and hit that like button. Thanks, guys.
Solid video from Christopher Narcan. I appreciate it. Solid content. It was nice. It was concise. You know, it talked about his recent drama ongoings, if you will. You know, pretty solid. Pretty good video. I would recommend. Go ahead and, yeah, I'll be a good guy. I'm gonna go ahead and link Christopher's video up in the chat in case any of y'all want to check it out. Boom. Not bad. Not bad. What else do we got going on? Why am I getting recommended Copper Cab? An interview? Okay, you did. Tommy did an interview with Copper Cab? What the fuck, dude? Wild. My YouTube is so chaotic. So much shit going on. Let's look at the Neon drama. What's going on with Neon, bro? Neon arrested. Neon arrest explained in 1 minute. Wow. Who's this guy? Dwayne TV. Let's check his shit out. Or actually, wait. Sensitive Society did a video. I kind of like Sensitive Society. Let's check him out.
If this is real, this could potentially be one of the best days ever. Forget Chris.
I love that.
It's the mess.
Just straight up, just start right off the bat, just hating. I love it. We love to hate.
Get paid vacations at work. This day might be the greatest of all time. Today I woke up to quite a few people tagging me on Twitter, like this person right here. So the fact that it was in my face as soon as I opened the app, I was like, this is interesting. And the reason why this video didn't come out sooner or as soon as it dropped is because I was looking for proof. I was looking, well, where is this rumor coming from? What law did he break? And we're gonna get into all of that right now. We got this post with almost 4 million views in a few hours. Cake streamer Neon is being sentenced to 1 year in prison in Dubai for illegally filming. And we get drama alert. Keemstar saying Neon has not been arrested to 1 year in jail. This is not true. If Neon goes to jail for a year for being a complete douchebag and harassing people in public, will I celebrate it? Yes, that is hilarious. And I think that's one way to teach all of these goofy ass streamers to stop messing and stop harassing innocent people. I think that would send a good message to all of these annoying ass Twitch streamers, cake streamers that just harass people because they're 9 years old and they think it's a funny thing to do, mess with innocent people. So this is the moment where he allegedly got arrested and was on his way to jail.
All cameras are off. I just want to let you know we're trying to work with you guys. I'm really sorry.
Start a Fallout series. The new show that just came out is really good. Yo, dude. Yeah, I've been thinking about it. I was actually playing a little bit of New Vegas yesterday. I did a pretty long stream yesterday. I was playing, started up a new character on New Vegas. Yeah, dude, I've watched a little bit of the show. I'm probably gonna keep watching it later today. It's actually really fucking good. I dig it.
Sorry.
If we can't film it, it's a problem. We can just leave if that's a... But the people
guest services said we're okay. If it's not okay, we can leave. We don't want problems.
We go to the office and after
you take it. Okay,
give me all your ID.
I'm so sorry, sir.
So I understand that it's not official, right?
Are we going to jail? Are we going to jail? Oh. Where are we going?
To the office, they said.
Bro.
But we went to guest services. That's where... Okay, guest services is where we got permission, ma'am. I want to let you know.
They started to look.
Guest services is where I got permission, bro. Is guest services in charge of the fucking laws of this like war-torn nation? What the fuck? Or no, not war-torn nation. I'm thinking of the wrong Middle Eastern country. Okay, my bad. Dubai is not currently war-torn, I don't think. So, just got to provide some clarification for the folks at home. But, like, you gotta be fucking careful, dude, depending which countries you're in and where you can film, where you can't. That's the deal with IRL live streamers. That's their whole fucking gig is they're just filming all the fucking time. Can you at least do a little bit of fucking research on where you're going to, man? And, like, can you, can't you? You know, can... Or, I should say, can you not? I just feel like they hardly even look into it. I feel like they just show up with their camera and they're like, all right, let's go. No? Where's the content? It's like, bro... You're gonna get fucking arrested in, like, a foreign country, bro. Like, foreign... Y'all thought American prisons are bad, dude. Go to some other countries. I'm not gonna lie, though. Dubai's probably got a pretty sweet prison. Prison system. Maybe not. I don't know. I just look how rich their fucking country is, and I'm like, well... take the sledgehammer. We're gonna make ourselves a little toy. Mix the fire axe and the sledgehammer.
You gotta do the most... Oh, shit. You gotta do the most basic bare minimum fucking research before you, you know, make these kinds of decisions. Because it can land you in a foreign prison, which is not a fun place to be at.
Look into it because I'm not from Dubai, believe it or not. I don't live there, so I don't know the laws. You know, just one simple Google search tells you everything you need to know. It says filming permits in Dubai are required by anyone who is looking to film in public places. They can be obtained by the Dubai Film and Television Commission.
Bro, like literally right there. You gotta get fucking permission and shit. You gotta get like licensing, like proper licensing. And they're like, oh, well, we just thought we could show up with our fucking cameras and just hit live. And it's like, bro, come on, dude. Y'all deserve whatever the fuck's coming your way for being so stupid, for being so reckless.
And then it says you do not require a filming permit for weddings, events, educational purposes, colleges and schools, press conferences, and any filming for personal use. Now, what Neon was doing...
Okay, maybe I spoke too soon. Technically, though, he's not filming for personal use since he's live streaming, right? Like, that would be my thought. I don't know.
Dubai, it wasn't for personal use. It certainly was not educational. It was to live stream on Kick in front of 10,000 botted people. This is his Kick page. He was pretty active 9 days.
I love how the guy said 10,000 botted people. He's not beating the bot allegations, bro. No way.
9 days ago on that grind, 8 days ago, 6 days ago, and he hasn't posted anything to Kick since last week, which gives the whole arrest for 1 year a little bit more credibility. Shouldn't it be common sense if you travel to a foreign country to at least know the basic rules? Because throughout all of North America, you can film in public, you don't need permissions, you can just film, live stream in public, you can do whatever you want. How do you not check this? Dude, it was like one click away. It took me like 5 seconds. Oh, can I film anybody? Can I live stream in public? Could all of this be faked and staged to get him more attention? Yes. Would I be surprised if this is fake? Absolutely not. We all know what kind of person Neon is. He does everything for clout and anything for views. And the thing is, yeah, people talk about it. It goes viral on Twitter. People like me and others make videos on it. But it really doesn't grow his page. And I think he's got to realize this is not the way to go. Because sure, people know you exist, but they just watch the video, they move on. They don't watch the video and they're like, I don't want to see Neon. If that was the case, I think he would have, I don't know, 500,000 followers. Him what bad stuff is happening to him.
This is where we got permission, ma'am. I want to let you know. So anyone who could clear this up is going to be in guest services as well.
Oh, there's a Brooklyn's, believe it or not.
They didn't give us anything. It's just basically they were going to send...
That's the camera.
They said they were going to send... They took a picture of my passport, and they said they would send it to the WhatsApp group chat.
Close the door, not to close it.
Close. Put it down, bro. Put it down. What are you doing, bro?
How is this guy 20 years old and this stupid? After watching that clip, I'm just like, you know what?
20 years old and this stupid. I'll be honest. You know, some of us were pretty fucking stupid when we were 20 years old. But yeah, I do see where he's coming from. Like, I don't. Neon's a fucking retard, bro. This kid sucks.
Well, I'd give him 5 years. And here we have one of his friends, Aiden Ross, coming to the rescue. And this is why this fucking kid never learns his lesson. It's because he always has people around him that are going to save him, that are going to defend him no matter what he does.
I'm doing everything that I can do to try to help. But people around him made it really hard.
You are one greedy bastard.
Because there's clips like...
I did not mean to give him my fucking...
I'm not gonna say specifically who you guys give it to.
Bro, I was not trying to give you my fucking katana, bro. Give me my katana back, dude. The fuck? No, sirree. No, I don't want him to defect. That's an L. I just lost the katana.
Someone around him mocked him pretty bad to where it's like, they fucked it up. I'm not gonna lie. The only thing I'll say is, it's sticky, bro. It's a very sticky situation. I see people, my crew talking about it, and it's not a script, bro. It's real life.
The thing with...
I hate how Aiden says, it's sticky, bro. It's like, pause. What the fuck? That sounds weird out of context. It's very sticky.
the situation. It's like, oh, okay, you got to clarify. Like, what the fuck were you talking about for a second? See, I can get it. I guess, okay, I'll get the fucking broadsword. It's not as cool as the katana, but whatever. This guy, this old fuck Bill, bro. Why the fuck? How could I be so careless? How could I be so reckless? I gave him my katana. Why?
People like Neon, is that they've lied their whole career. I mean, this is the same kid who pretended to die like 6 different times on YouTube to get views and subscribers. Neon is a perfect example of the boy that cried wolf, and it's like, Frank, who's going to believe him at this point? And it's like, we genuinely care.
Bro, I was just in the fucking Americana casino. Why couldn't you have told me this earlier, bro? Come on. Bill, get your ass over here, bro. Let's hustle it up. Get your ass over here, you old fuck. Stealing my katana. The fuck, dude?
If he gets arrested for a year, here's the thing, right? If it turns out to be real and he gets locked away for a year, I'll oil up when we hit 500,000 subscribers. This is the only way people like him are going to learn his lesson. And not only him, but every single other cake streamer who acts like him in hopes of getting big. Who cares if he gets arrested? I don't think anyone in this comment section is going to be like, no, Neon is going away for a year. What will I do now? My life has no meaning. This is a very hard day for all the 10-year-old Neon fans. My prayers are with you. The more I think about it, this might be 50-50, and by that I mean 50% real, 50% fake. I don't think anyone would be surprised by that. He lied again, that's new. And what this is going to do, because I eventually do think he will be caught, what this is going to do is next time something serious happens to him, no one is going to care. People are going to make videos, but no one's going to legitimately care about this dude. No one does. I don't even think the people around him care about him that much. They're just there to leech off his money, his clout, and his 25 seconds of fame before it dries out, and next time you see Neon kidnapped by the Mexican cartel, it's gonna be like, sure, I'm sure that happened. And the only person that is to blame is Neon. I'm looking at this post with 4 million views, and the responses are just, thank God. Deserved. Maybe streamers will stop harassing people when doing IRL streams now. We got what we wished for. Goated movie, by the way. Extremely underrated. This pack hit different. Yeah, we're definitely smoking that Neon pack.
This pack hit different, dude. God damn it. Smoking that Neon pack. Fucking L. Rip Bozo, dude. Fuck that kid. Where is... What am I looking for? Yeah, Rags Mags. That's what I'm looking for. Rags Mags. What a fucking name for a bookstore. What a name.
So, yeah, everyone's just celebrating, having a good time. I can't blame them. I pray for this and it happens. If this is a downfall of Neon, I'm staying prayed up. But at the same time, it's a double-edged sword because now there will be no more content to make on Neon. And now I will officially go homeless and need to go get a real job. So, for my benefit, I hope he's free. Free Neon. Actually, I'm going to tweet that. Hashtag free Neon. Free him. I need to make more content off of him and his stupid ass. That's all the information we have for now. I will definitely keep you guys updated if anything else drops, if anything crazy happens, if there's a plot twist. To make one thing clear, I want to say this. Yes, it is illegal to film without a proper permit unless it's for the reasons we took a look at earlier. The other stuff with him being sentenced to 1 year and all this other stuff, that is yet to be seen. Hopefully it's real.
Frank,
if it is,
a guy on a yellow motorbike riding around.
Subscribe.
How's it gonna be called Rags Mags and it looks like a Von Mar, bro? Like that name, Rag Mags. I hear I hear the name Rags Mags, and yeah, what's the store called Rags Mags? Like on the map and like on the wiki and shit, but the sign outside is just rag singular, like no plural. I'm gonna kill the fuck out of these guys. These guys are getting literally brutalized. Stupid looters. Get fucked, dude. Fucking bozo. Fucking looting me, bro. You ain't stealing my fucking money. You little bitch. Get fucked, dude. You guys suck. Ooh, the money hacker? I actually want one of those. Give it to me. leadership. That's what we're looking for. That was a solid video by Sensitive Society. At least I know what's going on with Neon. Now I can finally sleep easy at night, knowing I've been updated on the real news of the world. Can't believe this hasn't been... I'm not watching Oompa. What the fuck? Woman mouth wired shut after vicious attack. What the fuck am I getting recommended, dude? What the fuck? How about no? How about no? Jojo Siwa. This bitch sucks. I fucking hate. Yeah, we're out here hating. We're hating this morning. We're hating on children. Fuck Jojo Siwa. It's that one clip of that one guy from Loiter Squad, Earl Sweatshirt or whatever. He's like, yeah, we hating. Keep scrolling. We out here fucking hating. I'm a hating ass. And then he's, you know, I can't say the word, but, you know.
Okay, so I've been seeing a ton of news about JoJo Siwa recently. If you just look up her name on Google, there's like so many stories on this girl, okay? JoJo Siwa spent $50,000 on cosmetic procedure. Quote, very insecure JoJo Siwa, 20, spent a whopping $50,000 on cosmetic surgery. And it's just like all these articles by these washed up tabloid legacy media, you know, publications that I'm not reading, okay? We ain't reading that. Is there Subway Surfers gameplay that's gonna accompany this article? Will there be footage of a car rolling down a hill that I can look at while this reads itself to me? No? Okay, no thank you. Dude, I'm Gen Z, I'm illiterate. I'm not reading articles, especially about JoJo Siwa anyway. Yeah, so I went to something very visually stimulating, YouTube.com. To look up JoJo Siwa's name because I wanted to figure out what was happening with her. And I didn't see anything about this whole $50,000 cosmetic procedure thing, but what I did see is that she released a new video called Karma. And oh my god, the dislike bar got...
Yo! Those dislikes, dude. Procedure the thing. Ratio? Is that she released a new 149K likes and as opposed to the 720,000 dislikes. Then again, though, I don't know. I've heard slight, like, because here's the thing. You can't see dislikes on YouTube anymore, even though technically they are still counted behind the scenes. That being said, there's certain things you can use, like overlays or whatever the fuck. Like, there's, like, some sort of an overlay you can use to where it'll, like, kind of, like, modify YouTube to where you can see the dislikes. But I don't know. I've heard mixed things on that tool. Basically, I've heard, like, that the counter for the dislikes isn't accurate, so I don't know exactly, but, dude, that's weird. Normally, the inaccuracies come from, like, oh, it's a little bit off, but it's like, no, if it's 720,000 dislikes, bro, that's hilarious. Quite literally hilarious, bro. Yeah, I don't, like, this kid has got some serious fucking problems. That's my honest take on it. JoJo Siwa needs help, like, needs to go to church or something.
Video called Karma, and oh my god, the dislike bar got Oppenheimer. Dude, I didn't even know you could get this many dislikes for this many views. Lil Nas X literally was throwing it back sensual style on the devil, literally Satan, and he got more likes than dislikes. This video, this song might be the worst thing I've ever heard, or it must be, right? Because how on earth do you get this many dislikes on a video? Did she like announce like a war or something in this video? Did she say, hey, if you made it to the end of this video, let's invade Iraq? Did she? I don't know, I haven't seen it, but she must have said something crazy in this video in order for her to get this many dislikes. Now, unfortunately, I can't watch it because obviously the music in this is all claimed, it's copyrighted, but I guess we can like watch like little clips of it to see what's happening here. So, okay, I already don't like what I'm seeing here. What is this? We got some sort of, is she spraying
this one?
Okay, so it looks like the Titanic will not be hitting the iceberg. Very cool. So, interesting. They're on, like, this naval cruise ship right here. Maybe she actually is going to Iraq. Like, I mentioned that earlier, ironically. But who knows where they're supposed to be headed. I mean, it doesn't seem like anyone's steering this thing. And everyone's on the deck doing their little dance, their TikTok renegade. So, who knows who's in the cockpit, where they're steering this. Maybe the dude's got ethnic grudges, you know? Okay. No, thank you. Okay, very cool.
Ew, bro, come on, dude. It's not the fact that it's like a lesbian thing. That's fine, all right? We're definitely pro-lesbians around here, right? It's just that, like, it just comes off as such a weird grift. And my thing with JoJo Siwa is she's been so fucking famous ever since she was, like, a young kid that she doesn't know how to just not be famous and just be a normal fucking person. So everything she does has to be some sort of a spectacle, has to be some sort of... I have to show the whole world this and that, and I just feel like it's due to her being, like, a broken child, bro. The JoJo Siwa autobiography is gonna go insanely hard when she's, like, 30 and her brain actually develops, like, and she realizes, wow, like, growing up that famous was, like, not, it's almost like it's not healthy. It's almost like it's, like, not a good thing. Yeah. I need to watch this whole video. I probably don't, but I want to hear somebody bully the fuck out of JoJo Siwa, so we're going to keep watching.
Okay, okay, and that's okay. All right, we're going to add to this number right here. We're going to slap a dislike on there. No, thank you. Okay. Okay. It doesn't get better the second time. Oh my god.
Bro, what the fuck?
It's like, if we were the last two people on Earth, what would we do? And apparently the answer to that question is dry hump on an island. This is number one trending on music, by the way. Dude, oh my god, it's not even June. Like, you had to wait 2 months to become acceptable, and it's not even June. It's not even Pride Month. And even if it was, I feel like I don't know if that makes us any better, to be honest with
you. It's enough. We're out. I'm tapped out. Sorry, Achito. Solid video. Everybody go check out Achito. He's pretty solid. I dig Achito's content, you know, not terrible. JoJo Siwa trying to pull off the kiss look, but failing miserably. Yeah, everyone's been roasting her. They say she looks like a fucked up Gene Simmons. Gene Simmons did it better. Which I agree. 100% I agree. How do I fucking... Dead air. I can pop out the dashboard? What? That's kind of cool. Not know I could do that. Fair enough. Yeah, fuck. It's really about all I had in terms of content today, guys. Wanted to fire up a short little stream, you know, right the wrongs of yesterday, since yesterday's stream got way out of control and kind of ended abruptly, whatever. Never mind. We're not going to talk about that. I'm just kidding. Yeah, this is basically where I'm going to be ending the stream for today. Appreciation to everybody who came out. It just lagged there for a second. What the fuck? Appreciation to everybody who came out to the stream today. Everybody, all the chatters, all the, you know, likes and shares and all that stuff. Said it would be a shorter stream today, which, you know, I was not lying. I got some other shit I got to attend to, some other business, if you will, I must attend to today. That being said, thank you to everybody who came out. God, I'm so bad with outros, bro. Here, just let me cue up some music. Cue something up right quick. And we'll just go out on a song. Boom. Do a little bit of that, a little bit of... So disorganized today. Thank you to everybody who came out and supported the stream. Make sure to share the channel with your friends. If you enjoyed the content here, Voltage Mike TV. Follow me on Twitter. My Twitter's down in the description. You can get, like, notifications every time I go live. I tend to tweet it out on there. Titties. I don't know. That's the way we end it. Everybody have a good Saturday. Have a good weekend. Deuces.